Very good day to my dear lecturer and to my team members. Today, my friends and I are going to talk about MSM Malaysia Holding Berhad, about the company background, which was incorporated in 10 March 2011. It is manufacture processed sugar product, market them and sell to the customer. There are total number of employee which was working in the company. The number of employee is 1,262 employee working in the company. About the product and services, the classification are operate in two segments, which is processing of sugar and another is the selling and distribution of refined sugar, rubber and palm oil. A system that is one-time delivery efficient is expertly controlled by the MSM logistic. There are three different type of grade of refined sugar categorized, which is the groups. About the group, the first group is coarse granulated sugar, the second group is fine granulated sugar, and the last part is caster. It also packaging in variety sizes and customized to the specification and comfort of the customer.
MSM have located their factory, warehouse, and main office at different location in Malaysia. They also have trading hub in the Dubai. MSM Prime Berhad is located at the Seberang Prime Pulau Pinang. The places is strategic because it's near to the Pinang Port and business area. And also, they have their own jetty. Next, we go to the MSM Palace. MSM Palace have their own sugarcane plantation and make them the supplier. Plantation is close to the refining process plant and this will minimize the transportation cost. The last factory is MSM Tanjung Langsat. MSM Tanjung Langsat was the largest standalone sugar refinery in Malaysia. It is located at the Tanjung Langsat Port and a project to cost efficiency, also to reduce labor intensive costs. Next, we go to the main office, MSM Logistic. MSM Logistic is the main logistic arm supplies sugar effectively to the MSM Price exclusive customer across Malaysia, connect wide variety of area and major cities across Malaysia to produce optimal result. Trading Hub. MSM Trading Hub International DMCC, located at Dubai. It was chosen because the time zone appropriate. It is also located in the middle of the world sugar trade market that cover Asia, Europe, and America. It uses to approach to their close rival, which are United Kingdom and Switzerland.
My recital, I think it's very vital to rock around. That's right, on top. It's tricky. It's tough, like, here we go.
Facility layout is an arrangement of a different aspect of manufacturing in an appropriate manner as to achieve desired production results. An effective of a facility layout ensures that there is a smooth and steady flow of a production materials, equipment and manpower at minimum cost. Facility layout and design is an important component, which is both in terms of maximize the effectiveness of a production process and meeting the needs of employees. Facility layout are flexible more than ever because once the position ship and receive the departments at one end of the building. Now, the shipbuilding constructs so that deliveries can be made directly to points that they use of between the factory. Objective of facility layout. Number one, to provide optimal space to organize the equipment and to facilitate movement of goods and to create safe and to comfortable the work environment. Number two, to promote order into production towards a single objective. Three, to reduce movement of workers, raw material and equipment. Fourth, to promote safety of a plant as well as its workers. Five, to facilitate extension or a change in layout where to accommodate new product line of or technology upgradation. The last one is to increase production capacity of an organization.
There are three design of facility layout, which is flexibility, space utilization, and capital. Flexibility is where the company have their own place to cut on their own flexibility, which is the flexibility means here are the flexible of the company give their facility layouts in their company, where we can see the company itself give the facilities look smart in their construction at first. And then space utilization, the operation SMM sugar management, where you can see the operation looks great and neat. In order to operate a great facility, the company itself have to be more comfortable with its worker and its machine, where we can see the management itself have a good facility and it's really manageable. 3. Capital. MSM Sugar have a good way to minimize its own capitality, where it was seen obviously, and it's really good to decrease the production of their product. And we can see the product was produced smartly. There are three of facility layout, which is line layout, functional layout, fixed position layout, cellular technology layout, and combined layout. Line layout is known as product layout, where arrange activities in the line according to a sequence of operation that needs to perform to assemble in a particular product. Functional layout, this is a facility layout which is also known as a process layout, where the groups relate to the activity together in departments, department or work centers according to process or function they perform. Fixed position layouts, where a kind of typical of project in where the product is produced was to fragger bulky or heavy to move it. Cellular technology layout, which is attempt to combine the flexibility of the process layout with the efficiency of a product layout, which is based on the company concept, a group technology GT, dissimilar machine or activity a group by any kind or like work centers, call cells to produce a process family or parts to customer with kind of similar equipment. Combined layout is a kind of design to process a single model or type of product, can be used to process more than one type of product but not efficiently.
Hello, I am Jeevadashini Sativelu. Now, I am going to conclude our video presentation. MSM Malaysia Holding Berhad is Malaysia's leading refined sugar producer and one of the largest sugar refiners in Asia. The company manufactures a range of sugar products ranging from refined sugar of different grain sizes, brown sugar, liquid sugar, and catering a wide range of consumers' needs and demands. The company holds a good marketplace because of its good management. They are each and every process, starting from place, choosing, until product delivery to customers, is well planned and organized. In 2019, MSM produced 1,073,888 tons of refined sugar. 83,341 tons are catered for the export market. Now, MSM expands its value chain across upstream and downstream segments to its drive growth. MSM also aims to expand their exports to the new market as their production capacity increases.
Welcome to MSM, a market leader in sugar production in Malaysia and one of the top 5 refined sugar producers in Asia. As part of the FGV Group, a globally integrated diversified agri-commodities company, MSM Holdings is involved in the production, marketing and sale of sugar with a refining capacity of 1.25 million metric tons as of 2014. its two key sugar refineries, MSM Prai, opened by the first Prime Minister of Malaysia in 1964, and the MSM Perlis refinery in Chuping, provide this refining capability, which has over the years evolved to include highly automated production lines, coupled with an expansive and efficient nationwide distribution network. Sugar products are distributed across Malaysia via road and rail, while the in-house logistics subsidiary, MSM Logistics, operates a fleet of trucks catering specially to major industrial customers. In January 2010, both MSM Prai and MSM Perlis under the PPB Group were acquired by Felda Global Ventures Holdings Berhad, or FGV. This subsequently led to the incorporation of MSM Malaysia Holdings Berhad on 10th March 2011, continuing a sugar heritage dating back to the formation of the Malayan Sugar Manufacturing Company Limited. The company was listed on the main market of Bursa Malaysia on 28th June 2011, with 234.56 million shares being issued, with a par value of RM3.38 per share. MSM offers a wide range of sugar products to cater to the consumer and industrial market segments. These products include fine-grained sugar, which is found in the PXX and P1S grades, coarse grain sugar or P1, castor, icing, and the soft brown grades comprising PB and P4. With a strong and constant emphasis on delivering high-quality products, the MSM refineries have gained recognition through various certifications that include, amongst others, the ISO 9001 Quality Management System, HACCP or Hazard Analysis and Critical Control Point, and FSSC 22000, both of which relate to food safety, cereal product certification, halal, kosher, as well as OSAS 18001 for occupational health and safety. MSM's high-quality products are readily available throughout Peninsular Malaysia through an efficient and comprehensive distribution network via road, rail and sea links. The main refineries cover the northern region, while the Sungai Buloh and Johor Bahru warehouses in Selangor and Johor cater to the central and southern regions respectively. In addition, an appointed warehouse supports markets in East Malaysia. With a growing demand for MSM products abroad as well, ready and convenient access to the country's main ports enable these products to be exported to countries in the region like Singapore, South Korea, Hong Kong, China, New Zealand, Indonesia, Vietnam, Pakistan, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Australia, and the Pacific Islands. People are a key asset in MSM's operations. A highly efficient and dedicated workforce of about 900 employees, led by a dynamic management team, ensure a high-quality range of sugar products that are well-known domestically as well as internationally. MSM's management continues in its tireless efforts through mergers and acquisitions, as well as strategic initiatives to propel the company to be among the top 10 global sugar manufacturers by the year 2020.